Hello, I'm Jamila Musayeva, an international social etiquette consultant and the author of two books, Etiquette, The Least You Need to Know, and Afternoon Tea Etiquette. For those inquiring about my books are only available in hard copy print in English language here in Azerbaijan, but you can also order a signed copy by emailing me. I'll link it down below here as well in the description box. If you are a new viewer on my channel is about etiquette, soft skills, and self-development. If you're interested in all of that, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button. For all my old viewers, welcome back to the channel. I'm happy to see you here. Reading your feedback and seeing how much you loved the first edition of Common Etiquette Mistakes Part 1, I decided to do a second series called Common Etiquette Mistakes Part 2. So without further ado, let's look at 10 common etiquette mistakes. Common mistake number one is failing to introduce people to each other. Unfortunately, I've seen this happen a lot of the times when, let's say, you're walking with your friend and you meet an acquaintance of yours and you start chatting with them, you know, small talk, and completely ignoring your friend, forgetting to introduce them to your acquaintance. This is a huge etiquette mistake. What you have to do in this case scenario is give a little bit of information about your friend as well as your acquaintance. Let's say your acquaintance is John and your friend is Adam. You say, you know, John, this is Adam. He's a longtime friend of mine. We met in college. Adam, this is John. He and I have been working on this project together. He really likes basketball. By the way, Adam is also a huge fan of basketball. A little bit of an information about each other and then something that they might have in common so that the conversation can flow with the three of you together. Common etiquette mistake number two is when you're passing an aisle in a theater or cinema, passing it with your back facing to the person that's seated. That is a gross etiquette mistake. I want you to take a moment and visualize this. So here you are seated down and the person's passing by with their back towards you. So at your eye level, imagine what you're getting to see. It's not a pleasant imagery. Now what you have to do is you have to face turn around with your face towards the person that's seated, slightly bending backwards so that you're not very close to the person, and then pass by. Common etiquette number three is not RSVPing or RSVPing very late. RSVP is the abbreviation of a French word that stands for Répondez s'il vous plaît, which means please respond. It's different from an invitation that says regrets only. In regrets-only invitation, you only respond if you're not coming. With RSVP, you are responding either way. If you're coming, you're saying, yes, I will come. If you're not coming, you're gonna say, no, I cannot come. And then give a brief reason why you can't make it. Why is RSVPing so important and why do invitations have an RSVP line? It is because the host needs to know if you're coming, and if you are, then they need to prepare food for you, arrange a seating place, maybe, you know, prepare a gift if they're doing gifts at the end of the party. Not RSVPing shows your disrespect towards the host because they don't know if they should be expecting you or not. But if you RSVP past the deadline, it might get the host into trouble, you know, running around last minute, trying to get a chair for you, trying to get a gift for you, or maybe prepare an extra meal for you. Because when a host prepares for the party, they need to plan way ahead to know who's gonna come, how many dishes they need to prepare, how many seating places they need to arrange. And therefore, RSVPing is important. If you want to be a nice guest, please make sure to RSVP. And as we all know, a nice guest is always welcomed. Common mistake number four, when you're doing business in Middle East or any Muslim country, please make sure not to pass your business card with your left hand. Left hand is deemed to be dirty because it's used for certain hygienic purposes, and that way you should not be passing anything with your left hand if you want to show respect. So business card should only be passed with a right hand. Not knowing this can get you into trouble or start off your relationship really badly with someone from that region. Common etiquette mistake number five is handshaking someone while seated down. I've observed this on multiple occasions when people extend their hand while seated down for a handshake. This is not proper. This doesn't show respect to the person who you're reaching your hand out. Make sure to stand up and then extend your hand for a handshake. if there's something on your way, there's a physical obstruction between you and the person that you're supposed to extend your hand out, if you cannot physically get up, slightly elevate yourself from the seat, then extend your hand. But let's say in a very, very rare case, you are in a packed cinema, it's very difficult for you to get up, then, and you need to do a handshake, then only you can say, "I'm sorry, I cannot stand up, but I would like to shake your hand." And then you extend your hand for a handshake. It is only permissible for women in a social setting to be seated while shaking hands. Only social setting and only women. Common etiquette mistake number 6 is seasoning your food before trying it. The message that this sends to the person who has cooked the meal, either be it a host at, you know, if you're attending someone's party at home, or a chef if you're at the restaurant, is that I don't really trust your cooking skills and I think I need to season this food better. Do not season it before trying it. Again, seasoning can be different, your preferences for salt and pepper can be different, and that's understandable, but try not to season it before you've actually tasted the food. An interesting story from history, presumably, I don't know whether it's true or not, but there was a legend that Henry Ford, before hiring a person for an executive position, would take them out for lunch. And if that person seasoned the food before trying it, he wouldn't hire him. So imagine what an important test this was, not to season the food before trying it. Common etiquette mistake number 7 is taking a sip of water or perhaps wine while your food is still in your mouth. Make sure that you first swallow the food and then take a sip of water or wine. You would think it's common sense and it's a basic rule of etiquette not to mix water and food together in your mouth, but I've seen it happen oftentimes in even fancy restaurants. It happens more often when people are eating, for example, a steak and then taking a sip of wine. Make sure to first swallow that piece of steak and then take a sip of wine. Common etiquette number 8 is leaving your used napkin on a plate that contained food particles in it once the dinner is over. I've seen it quite often, more often than I would have liked to see that, is when a person would pick the napkin and just place it right on the plate. Never do that. If you finished eating your meal and there is a plate in front of you, make sure to pick the napkin that's already been used and place it on the left side of the plate. If, however, you've finished your meal and your plate has been cleared out, so in the center there is nothing, only then can you place your napkin in the middle and then leave. Common etiquette mistake number 9 is toasting first when you are a guest. When you are a guest, you should first wait for the host to make a toast that's usually in your honor if you're an honorary guest, and then only you can return the toast, so return the favor by toasting to the host. Speaking of toasting brings me to the last point of today's video. Common etiquette mistake number 10 when it comes to toasting is toasting to your own self, or basically drinking to your own self. So when someone is toasting in your honor, do not touch the glass, or even worse, do not drink in your own honor. Just sit there and smile, appreciate the toast that has been given in your honor, and let the others raise the toast and drink in your honor. Thank you so much for watching this video until the very end. If you're still with me, I would like to make an announcement that I've launched my Patreon page, which I'll link down here as well in the description box below. You can join to become a patron of mine, whereby you'll be able to get access to exclusive videos that are called a series of videos that will be called Etiquette Lessons in the Movies. Each month, in the beginning of the month, I'll make the announcement of the movie that we'll be watching, and by the end of the month, I'll publish an exclusive video that's only available for patrons to get to see my comments and feedbacks discussing etiquette lessons or perhaps some mistakes that we have learned by watching the video. It's basically an etiquette movie club. If you're interested in that, please make sure to join. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!